I think the government should also make, should also construct as a secondary school that at the moment you know that my kid is from Kampala, he's just joining another school, of which that school should be a secondary school.
Gertrude Nachito, a mother of a child with a condition, says traditional schools do not admit children with hydrocephalus and spina bifida due to the challenges associated.
Most of the secondary schools do not admit people with wheelchairs, and it's hard for them. First and foremost, Gavin is a slow learner. He can learn, he's intelligent, but he's slow.
Nachito also urged the government to build another hospital to take care of children with the condition. She laments that Cure Hospital in Mbale is too far away and is the only specialist center in the country.
My sister told me that Gavin's head is swelling, so I was like, swelling? She said yes. We went to the hospital just to discover that Gavin had water in his head.
We may not have a hospital, but we can have a clinic. Because the things they use, they are very expensive. We can come up with a good construction and we put up a building and we start treating these children.
Patience Mbabazi, the founder of Hydrocephalus and Spina Bifida Initiative in Entebbe, has called on Good Samaritans to extend help to such children.
So it's the reason why I call everyone, whoever would love or wish to have children, normal children in the country, to come in and contribute, and we have a special clinic for these children.
Esther Namboka, the Girls Forum International Chairperson, notes that there is a lot of stigma for children, which causes the mothers to hide them away from the public.
There's a lot of stigma for these children, and that's why most of the parents of these children resort to hiding the children under the beds.
Report by Godfrey Sempija for the news in Entebbe.